ladies and gentlemen. As you can imagine, I have had kind of an interesting career path, right? I started at 9 years old as a pool hustler. It got me into pickpocketing, turns into con games, swindles, hustles. The very natural progression was to become a motivational speaker. So I am very proud to say that I started a seminar called the It Ain't Magic Seminar. It is a 3-series talk, one on goal setting and achievement. Once you learn the secrets in the seminar, it ain't magic to achieve personal and professional goals. Kind of catchy, right? We have another one on the anatomy of a con game. Yes, you can learn the inner workings of a con game. The third one, the important one I think for this group over here, is one on memorization techniques. Sir, have you ever met somebody and 3 seconds later you can't even remember their name? All the time. It's so frustrating, isn't it, right? He goes, how does this possibly happen? I'm going to teach you ways to remember things much better. Now, I did not compete this year, but last week in Poland, they held the World Memorization Championships. I think that's what it's called. And the guy that won was from the Ukraine. He memorized an entire deck of cards in order. The question is, how long did it take him? What would you think, sir? How long would it take to memorize the entire deck of cards in order?
2.5 minutes.
2.5 minutes, that's a pretty good guess. He actually did it in 17 seconds. Seven, right? You can look this up online. You couldn't make this stuff up. His video went viral. He was all over ESPN. When I saw the publicity this guy got, I thought two words. Challenge accepted. So tonight, right here at the Magic Castle, I will attempt to break the professor's record and actually memorize this deck of cards in 15 seconds. Now, when I looked up the record to find out the statistics, it was actually very simple. You have to obviously use 52 cards, right? And the cards have to be shuffled up to obviously to keep everything fair. We'll mix these cards up like so. If you would give just one cut. What had happened was that he actually had some different people select a card. I'm gonna speed this up. Just touch any one of these. It's not there. Okay, we're gonna give you a small packet of cards. It doesn't matter how many. Mix these cards up, right? We don't want them to be in any particular order like that. And then make sure there's more than 5, less than 15. More than 5, less than 15 cards. Okay, looks like they, yeah, okay. Hand them to different people. So everybody gets a card, right? I want different people. You can look at it or you cannot look at it. I don't want you to think I'm gonna read your mind. Just hold on to the cards. We're gonna use them in a little while. Yeah, just take one down, pass it around to the next person. The lovely lady right on over here. You are gonna be the starter. Okay, so you are going to say very clearly and loudly, ready, set, go. When you say that, and not a second before, I will begin to turn these cards over one at a time, and in 15 seconds, I will memorize that entire deck of cards. Now, we need somebody that has a watch. It's somebody that has a second hand. You got a second hand. Excellent. Yep. You say, ready, set, go. You take the time. And what I want you to do, sir, is I want you to go 5 seconds, 10 seconds, and then time. Got it? 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 10 seconds, so I know where I'm at. Okay, so I can kind of pace myself. I can count on you. All right, here we go. Thank you. You say ready, set, go, and we go.
Ready, set, go.
Here we go. Breaking the world record, ladies and gentlemen. 15 seconds for the entire deck of cards.
5 seconds.
Already? Okay. We're going to...
Ten.
Okay, wait. Time out. This doesn't count. I just realized that what
15.
If... What? I said this doesn't count. I called that. This is time. What happened if your watch isn't, like, correctly synchronized, right? That might not have been fair time. Perhaps we need a second person. We have a second person down over here that also has a second hand. Is that someone you got? He's got a second hand over there. Fantastic. I mean, perhaps you are of Ukrainian descent. Maybe your uncle has the record right now, and so therefore you're trying to make me not be able to do this. So here we go. So what's going to happen is, you are going to say ready, set, go, and then both of them will take their time, and then at that time, I'm going to turn the cards over not a second before, and then I'll try to memorize this entire deck of cards. Okay, so go ahead and recognize the entire deck of cards in 15 seconds or less. So here we go. We're now going to try to memorize. It is so hot in here. I don't know if you guys are as hot as I am. So here we go. Memorizing the entire deck of cards in 15 seconds or less. When you say ready, set, go, then we can begin. Any?
Ready, set.
Okay, wait. Now, I sense the skepticism in the room here that perhaps you're thinking this method isn't as valid as I claim it to be. And it is, and I'll prove it to you, because it is a method that I developed known as the Con Man Code. Yes, available in my lecture, you'll find out the Con Man Code, using a very specific algorithm that has not only the suits, but the values of the cards cross-referenced to develop 52 very distinct symbols, each one for a different card. And using this system, you can now memorize an entire deck of cards in 15 seconds or less. And I'll prove it to you. Let's get a card. How about this one? What card do you see here?
10 of clubs.
You see a 10? I don't see that. I see a case. A case is what this represents to me. And I'll prove it to you. If we open up the command code and we go to the 10 of clubs, which is right over here, you will see that this is in fact a case. Had you taken my seminar, you'd have already known that answer, wouldn't you? So what happens is, as I see each one of these images, I destroy it in my mind. I rip open the case. If it's a bunny rabbit, I tear off its ear. If it's like a little kitty cat, I tear off its tail. If it's like one of those cute wrinkly dogs, like a pug, right, I don't do anything to pugs. I love pugs. They're very adorable. But the point is that I destroy each one of these images. When I'm done, any image that remains whole has to be a card that you guys have, thus proving that I've memorized the entire deck of cards. In fact, what I can do now, we've got this, to go twice as fast, I can go twice as fast. You say, ready, set, go, I'll flip the cards over like that. Twice as fast.
Ready?
And actually, no, not yet. I'm explaining the trick to you. So what's going to happen is that this over here, this is a lady raking with a hoe like a spade. This over here, this is a doll. What I imagine is that she's raking a bunch of dolls so I can go twice as fast. Now you can see that there's no way that I can't possibly break the record. Breaking that record, now in 15 seconds, memorizing an entire deck of cards, and I feel very confident. So here we go. Whenever you're ready, you say ready, set, go. You got 5 seconds, and here we go, ready?
Ready, set, go.
Here we go. Now we're going for the world record, ladies and gentlemen. The calculator is eaten by the lion. The lion goes over to the spade.
Five.
We got five. Jeez, that's fast. All right, we're going to go over there. The doll we already got. We got the seven. We got the hail. We got the coal. Yeah. We got the home. We got the cash. And then we got over there, that is the king with the big diamond over there. Was that 15?
15.
I didn't get to them all. Awkward. <Yeah. laughs> I mean, how am I supposed to like memorize the deck if I can't even see the last two cards? Now some of you may think that these last two cards are marked. So maybe I do in fact know the value, and you'll see that they're not. There's no markings on the front, there's no markings on the back, so there's no way that I can know what those final two cards are, but thus I will still memorize this entire deck, proving to you that I have in fact done this. In fact, one of the cards that I have not seen yet, one of the cards is a bar of soap, which is the nine of spades. Who has the nine of spades? Somebody have the nine of spades? You have the nine of spades? We're gonna say, all of a sudden they're going, holy cow, maybe he's telling us the truth this whole time. What'd be the chances of that here at the Magic Castle? Say another one that I've seen is a lovely lady with a giant diamond, a queen of diamonds. Who's got the queen of, course, the appropriate one, the queen of diamonds for you. Let's see, another one that I have not seen is the, I've not seen the den, the two of clubs. Who's got the den? Who's got the den? The den is right on over here. I've not seen the hailstorm. That's the five of hearts. Who has the five of hearts? Is right on over there. I have not seen a safe. That is the eight of spades. Who has the eight of spades? Eight of spades. How many more do we have? How many more? We got two, that's it? Two cards? Okay, two cards. Let's see, one is red, one is black. You wanna see the red one or the black one?
Red.
Let's go with the red one. The red one is a little boy. A little boy with this little precious diamond, a jack of diamonds. Who's got the jack of diamonds? Jack of diamonds on over there. There's one card left. One card left, sir. You are the only one that knows what it is. Let's see. That I want you to think about that card closely. That card, if I got this correctly, that card is a kitty cat. It is a kitty cat, ladies and gentlemen. And if this is right, if this image actually matches the card that you have in your hand, sir, I want you to very loudly say, a new world record. Unofficial as it may be, but a new world record, ready? Is the card that you have the ace of clubs. A new world record, ladies and gentlemen. You got it.